Nice rock right there. Whoa, is that a good crappie? I think it is, dude. Oh boy. Which way you want to come? This side? This side? Wow. That's what we came for. Right there. Woof. It is a nice crappie. Wow. Man, sometimes when Mother Nature does not want to agree, and I mean, it's not a complaint. You hear me talk about the weather all the time. But I just love to go fishing. So I have to adapt, improvise, overcome. You've heard it all. But sometimes the bigger baits just aren't the answer when you got just terrible wind blowing in all your favorite crappie spots over deep weed. You just can't hold. You know, sure, the fish are there. You miss the bites because you got to react too fast with the movement, with the slip float. So come back into a little bay like this. I know the fish are getting ready to spawn. You're close to the shorelines and stuff. So I pick up just a little generic tube jig, okay? Multicolored, this one's red with some white, black, and chartreuse. A small slip float, my weight to get that tube jig down a bit quicker so the float is more vertical. And just real simple stuff, between 4 and 6 pound monofilament. The Pro 100 reel by B&M, and of course the SAM Super Sensitive. Put it out there, I can pitch all around the boat, just looking for fish. But it's about utilizing, you know, dissecting areas. I got the poles, so I'll go about 20, 30 feet at a time, put it down, and just fan cast all those areas with logs and rocks and a little bit warmer water temperatures away from that heavy winds. I got the sun beating down, so maybe just a little bit warmer. It's about 52, 50, 53 degrees, but just enough. I'm sure that as soon as the sun comes up, a bit more, more fish will pull in, they'll get tighter, and maybe catch them with a little tube jig. But for now, it's just looking for fish, hoping to catch fish on one of the most versatile and known baits for almost every species that swims, and that is the little tube jig. And in this case, little 1.5 or 2 inch micro tubes. Let's go and catch some crappie. Oh boy, look at that. You know what that is, don't you? That's tube jig crappie. Right near a tree too, eh? So textbook. So my first crappie on the tube of the day is a little guy. But once you tell you where you are, maybe, just maybe. Let's see. Hey, let's see. You got any big friends there? Do ya? Yep. Nice black one, eh? Nice black one. Sitting up along the shoreline, boy. Eating that tube jig, huh? Boy, look at him. Maybe I got one for taking a picture, eh? Tube jig, can't beat it. I love how these ones look in the spring. Tuxedo colors. Let's put a couple in there for some pictures. Ooh, Mother Nature. Mother Nature's playing havoc. So, you know, there's always different options of different baits. All the plastics I use, jerk bait, crank bait, spinner bait, everything tiny for crappie, including one of the best baits for bass, little tube jigs. There's so many on the market. We're going to try to catch some fish in this torrential storm-like conditions in Ontario in the middle of May with a slip float, my SAMs, and some little multicolored tube jigs. Let's try it. Now, there's a testament right there to me having those things at the back. They're not just bling boys. They keep me in one spot where I can stay stationary. I got my own floating dock anywhere I fish, 10 feet or less. And for things like this, when the wind's pushing me in, and those fish are in shallow water, it's like fishing for shallow bass or something. If you can stay back and fish don't see you, you have a lot better chance of catching them. Like that. Whoa. Decent, small, but still making my day, boy. Aren't you? Making my day. So you got a couple poles, both with the SAM Super Sensitive, two different little floats, the same little tube jigs, but one with red, black, and chartreuse, and one with dark green, with light green and black. Just changing up back and forth, zigzagging through this area and catching these crappies. I'll put one way up here by this rock, look. Uh-oh. Rock, warm water. Is there a big crappie there? Oof. That looks spooky. Yep. Wow. Dark one. I bet you was holding by that rock. Oh, a little male. Wow. Just nuts. Look at that. Look at it. I mean, look at that. There's no guesswork when they decide that tube jig's bouncing in front of their nose. They just go dump. Right where it should get. Right in the meat, huh? Oh boy. There he goes. You okay? Just in the top. Let him go back and do his business, right? Go on. Keep going. That would have made a little further cast, but amongst there's logs and rock and stuff, and you know that rock makes that water temperature, I don't know, a degree, 2 degrees more, and a little bit of heat. And if they're looking to think about spawning soon, a little bit of heat is a difference. Let's put it back in the same spot. Let's see if there's a big friend there. Okay, look at what colors. Confusing, but look at it. Doesn't look like a Christmas tree, you know? Right here, crappie candy, that's what this is. All the colors under the rainbow. Some are trying to escape, but I mean, I keep my options always open because I fish all across the United States and Canada. And you never know what color, where, when, or how. So when it comes to crappie tube jigs, I make sure I got tons of variety, tons of colors and options and stuff. So I'm ready for almost anything when John Smith in Arkansas tells me pink and chartreuse. Bill Smith in Eastern Ontario tells me chartreuse white. Jeff Smith tells me pink, white, black. You get the idea. Variety is the spice of life. When it comes to crappie tubes, you can never have too many. And they just engulf it and just slowly swim with it. And they keep twitching it to drive them nuts. Nice rock right there. Whoa, is that a good crappie? I think it is, dude. Oh boy. Which way you want to come? This side? This side? Wow. That's what we came for. Right there. Woof. It is a nice crappie. Wow. Look at that. Tube jig right through the nose, right through the hard spot. Skinny. One of the males. Look at. All beat up and stuff. But that's an Eaton-sized crappie right there. He's going in the box. Yeah, that's a nice fish right there, boy. Beautiful crappie. Go on, boy. Pitching. Dissecting. This is a perfect example of going through areas and just taking your time, pitching out and working it slow and catching the fish in front of you. Let's put it out. See if there's another one there. Right by the rocks. Warmer water. Right by the rocks. Wow. Yep. Here's a silver flash. Oh, he drops him by the boat. Let's put it right back out. Let's see if he's got a friend. Oh, wasn't the biggest crappie of the day, but still a fish. They got no idea I'm here. Look at those far pitches. There's another one there. Uh-oh. A better fish, I think. Look at them go out here. Man, are they scrapped because of that cold water. Look at them go. Where do you think you're going, buddy? Wow. Look at him. There's the male there. Hey, look at him. Wow. What a gorgeous looking fish. Look at that. Look who he's got that tube jig to. Oh boy. You talk about crappies, man. You talk about fun. That's fun and crappie right there. Wow. Beautiful black. Look at all the colors on him. I know, I'm going to let you go, okay, because I only want a couple. I like to catch some big ones. But, you know, crappie are weird, because look at them. They're almost all fins, like their body. The width. Okay, buddy. Ready, buddy? Ready? Go on. See ya. Right, here's the tube jig I first started with. Black with some red and chartreuse. Okay. I changed it up a little bit to one with a little bit of two-tone green with some blue and chartreuse. Again, on a little weighted slip float. This one I had the B&M Sam Super Sensitive 4-pound test monofilament. And another rod, you know, that's the TCB series, okay, by Leyland Lures by B&M. Again, really small float again. And this one just had a really simple white with chartreuse. Didn't have to go to that one very much. It was just the multi-tone ones were catching them. But I mean, it's so simple to catch these tube jig crappie. Light little B&M poles, you know, a pocket full of slip floats, tubes and stuff. Very inexpensive, but a great way to catch crappie on shorelines when it's too shallow and too windy to single pole them. Any more slappy happy crappie? Slap happy. I love these rocks. Yep, decent fish, I think, too. Look at them thrash. Wow. A lot of eaters along the shoreline, boy. We've got a few already. I just want to catch them on a tube. Look at that. 11-inch crappie. Let's see what else is there. I got a little closer to that tree. Let's see if he's got a big one there. Yep. Oh, big splashy one too. Look at this. Big splashy one. Oh, nice black one, eh? Wow. Yes, sirree. Nice black one. And I changed it up too. Look at that. I'll show you this. See a little green? Green with chartreuse. Maybe they see my tube jig too much. I'm not going to give them that much credit. But man, as soon as I change that color up, first cast again, bang, nice crappie. So, put him in there, he's nice and dark. Take a few pictures of some fish. Hey, what do you think, crappie? Yeah, we'll do that. And you see that? Changed up from the black with the red, went to the green, and went through the same area two or three times and keep catching fish. Caught three or four there. I move up 10, 15 feet, man. Not much. So I can keep making those pitches just ahead of the boat. Let her drift with the wind. I'm going. When I'm content, where I know I can see different rocks that are maybe 20, 30 feet ahead where I was. Poles down. Set up. Make my pitches. And see if I can find some new fish that haven't seen my little tube. Just decide just to destroy it. Boy, I thought there'd be one. There is one there. Oh, looks like a decent one too. Yeah, he's decent. I love it. Wow. Now that's what you call a system, man. Wow. Slowly, like a vacuum cleaner. I know. You're all scarred up. You want to do your business and stuff. But look at them. They got nice little black cheeks and stuff. Go on, little crappies. Go on. So you can do this too with a smaller boat. You don't have to have, you know, this is the boat I use for all my other filming and stuff, but you can use a power pole, make the thing of the micro, which goes straight down. Or if you have to, you just put a little anchor down and just once in a while, lift it up, drift 15 feet. If you don't have a trolling motor, it's easy as well. Drift 10, 15 feet, put the anchor down, come back up on front on your boat, make your casts, set it about 18 inches, let it settle, do a few twitches, just like that, and you just wait. They'll find you. If they're there, they'll eat the tube. But it's just a simple way to fish, man. Those tube jigs, you definitely got to put them in your tackle bag, your tackle box and stuff, and just fish along. Methodically work an area. Don't think on that one pass you can catch them all. Or just go in and make cast 20 feet from shore. Dissect the areas. Look where you caught the first couple, because that's your clue to where those fish might be holding. Whoa, Scrapper City. A dark one too. Look how these things fight. That's a nice crappies, man. Nothing wrong with that fish right there. Nothing wrong with that. Wow. Up into the meat. Just thick. Nice fillets on that. Boy. But we're here to have some fun and show you that tube jigs will continually catch everything that swims, including these beautiful Ontario crappies. Look at that, that's a good one. Oh boy. Yep, sir. Look at this one. Oh man, hey. Yes, sir, yes, sir. Just moving and catching. That's more than a handful right there, look at that. Wow. That's where I come crappie fishing, right there, boys. Right there. Let's put you in the box and take a few pictures of some of you fish. That's not trophies, but they are nice. In my line of business, I gotta take some pictures and show you that we are catching. Let's see if we can do some more. So I'm virtually just going through the whole area here, dissecting it, looking for fish, 10, 15 feet at a time, then put the poles down. Even if I don't catch, at least I know I'm just gonna dissect this little area right here. Another one. Whoa, oh, good one too. Look at the fighter. Oh man, a dark one. Wow, hey. I never get enough of you guys. Look how small you are too. You're just the thrill. The thrill. Little black male. Look at him. Wow. Let's put you back and see if you got a big one with you, huh? You got a big one here with you? Oof, wow, so cool. And black crappie, oh boy, nice black crappie. Which side? Oh yeah, whoa, look at him, wow. That's a decent one, look at him. Thank goodness for the tubes and finding some calmness, but again, right through the top yap. You talk about incredible. Right through the top. Take it at the bend, and there it goes. Just beautiful crappies, man. I know, boys. I got a nice feed at home. So we'll let you guys go. Tube jigs, boy. Tube jigs on a slip float. And what I'm fishing is about, well, along the shoreline, I would say 18 inches, then 2, 3, 4 feet. So some of those rocks up ahead of me there are like in about 3 feet of water. And the temperatures, as you see as I'm dressed, it's cool, man. So it's about 52, 53 in that tighter stuff, maybe a bit more, but a little bit of heat, they hold it. They're thinking about getting ready to do their spring deal. So tube jigs in different colors, I went from the red, black, with a little bit of white and stuff, to like the dark green, with light green, and blue and yellow. Let's see if I can get another one up in the same spot, by the rocks. Making far casts, staying back, and just doing light twitches like this. Light twitches. Hopefully they come over and just decide to eat it again. Any more up there? I need to put it right on those rocks. Let's see if I can put it right on it. Oh boy, there it is. Right on the rock. Wow. Wow's right. Little plates. Hey. That jig's right down. The odd fish has it right down, but most of them are just lip hooked. That's a testament to those sharp jig heads right there. One. Like, you talk about fun. That main lake out there, you can't tell by right there, but I mean, you hear the trees, it sounds like trains are coming through. The main lake driving down here is like 4 footers, but we came down safe, but just fine. Water's 53 degrees in here. It's away from the wind. The sun's on it. There's rock on it. There's wood. It's absolutely perfect for pre-spawn crappies. I don't see any nests anywhere. They're just slowly moving into the areas where they want to catch them and throwing that little tube jig. I mean, people have been using tube jigs since when? The caveman days, for everything. From ice fishing, to bass, to walleye, you name it. The little tube, what's doing it today? But there's a good one right there, wow. Whoa, wow. That's why I wear glasses. Wow, look at that one, eh? There's a plate. Now that's a crappie plate right there. Wow, I seen you come up and inhale that tube jig, dude. I mean, that was worth the price of admission right there. Just came through this whole area. Think about that, man. Casting all through here, okay? Casting all through here. Picking off the other ones. And a fat one was sitting right there beside that rock. Put it down, twitched it once, thump, rewarded with it right there. Polarization of glasses, you've got to have it. Protect your eyes from the UV, all the different rays. But I mean, fishing without it, there's a couple things I'll fish. There's a couple things I won't fish without. Eyewear, just got to have them, because that's the reward right there. Well, that's a wrap, man. What a morning. You know what? Came out. The wind just was wicked, man, but I knew I had a couple spots that might be sheltered, a little bit warmer where the fish might be, and take up my trusty tube jigs with a slip float, and man, oh man, single poling was an option, but this morning was really cloudy and stuff, and I just couldn't see anything. You know, the wind was coming in, gusts and stuff. It just makes it a lot harder. I like to be able to see them and put it on their nose, but another option is throwing that slip float, using the poles, staying back and making the pitches. They don't see you. They see that tube, they're gonna eat the tube. So next time, think about stocking up different plastics and stuff. Think about the tube jigs, because they still catch crappie. Appreciate you watching.